In this demonstration, I'm going to show how we can configure Advanced Insights to allow us to authenticate using Active Directory accounts. In the Advanced Insights interface, I'm going to go to the Administration node and click on Settings. Then under User Management, you'll find halfway down the page an option to enable Active Directory authentication. I'm going to check that box. If the domain that Advanced Insights is installed in is the same as the domain that your users are going to be authenticating from, then you'd need to provide no further details here. If you do have a more complex setup where the users are coming from an external domain, then you may need to provide an LDAP domain name here and some details of a service account that can be used to verify their details. I'm going to save that box now. Having done that, I'm going to move to the roles area. Here I'm going to create a new role for my help desk users. I'll give the role a name and assign it to a help desk group. If you don't see this AD group option, it's because you haven't yet enabled that Active Directory integration. I'm then going to move to the permissions tab. The permissions tab allows me to set which dashboard pages and which console actions and tools the help desk team should have access to. So I'm going to give them access to their hardware page and also the top level home dashboard. I'll give them access to operating systems, resources, and the software pages as well. I don't need to give them any of the administration roles, but I will give them all of the client actions. So this will allow them to do things like remote control and push restarts to machines. And also I'm going to give them modify collection rights. I can now log in as one of those users who's in that help desk group, just using their standard AD username and password. And what we will see is that they have access only to the views that I gave them: operating systems, software, hardware, and resources. The other thing that is interesting to note is that they have fewer devices presented in their console than I saw as an administrator. And that's because this help desk user has an RBAC role defined inside a configuration manager that only gives them access to a specified set of machines. So they only have access to one collection, and that collection just has these 14 devices in it. And so with that approach, using the role scoping that we have inside of Advanced Insights, and the RBAC rules that you can define for a device, for a user, in the Configuration Manager console, we can provide a tailored experience for all of your user groups.